angel Gabriel was sent from God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph, the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. Coming to her, he said, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at what was said, pondered what sort of greeting this might be. And the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He will be great, will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give him the throne of David, his father, and he will rule over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." But Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I have no relations with a man?" And the angel said to her in reply, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, Elizabeth, your relative, has conceived a son in her old age. And this is the sixth month for her who was called barren, for nothing will be impossible for God." Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word." And the angel departed from her. The Gospel of the Lord. Items on the agenda. One is to welcome all of our parishioners and friends of the parish from around the country and even the world, far away places like Nebraska and Ireland and other such places that are watching and joining us for our Mass on the internet. So welcome everybody. Also for our local people, a reminder that on Christmas Day, if you're feeling it better not to come to Mass, but watch instead starting on Christmas Eve, probably about 4:30 or so, we'll get the Mass going online. We'll record the 3 p.m. Out in the parking lot and then post that online for everybody who needs to stay home to watch online. Christmas Eve, Christmas Day, and then Christmas Day at high noon. We'll have communion for you. Pull through in the parking lot, and we'll take care of you in the car on Christmas Day at noon time. So, most welcome to everybody. That's that. Another item on our agenda comes by way of, in the bulletin, we have a little tribute and a thank you to Tim Collins, a retiring member of our finance council. A little bit of a hiccup at home keeps him from joining us today, but I do have a bunch of my finance council with me, and I'd like to point them out to you. We've got Steve Tully over here, and Bob Berry might be around somewhere. Nancy Tarantello, Ed Slater I see off on the flank over here, and Dan Dillon as well. We're to be honoring Tim this morning, but we'll do that at a later time. And meanwhile, do note the little tribute to him there in the bulletin. Take that home with you. He's retiring this year. We're going to have a bottle of champagne for him. Don't tell him I told you this. You'll spoil the secret. So we can toast in the new year with one job well done and a new year with one less responsibility here at the parish where he served in that post on our finance council for about 15 years, I think it was. So long that nobody can remember. That's a long time. So congratulations to Tim Collins and our thanks. One of my favorite saints, just because he's so big and colorful, is St. Bernard of Clairvaux. If you can imagine the dog, St. Bernard, then you've got a pretty good image of the guy himself, a big ox of a man, a knocker of heads, a great reformer, put up with few fools, but he had a beautiful poetic sight. He's the one who composed that prayer to Our Lady, "Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of Mercies, our life, our sweetness, our hope." He also had a beautiful sermon on today's gospel, in which he imagined the after all, the privilege of a lady to keep you waiting. And who knows, it was a prerogative she exercised. But think about that. All history waiting, the prophets waiting, the angels in heaven waiting, God's Spirit ready to get into action, waiting, the Word ready to be spoken and incarnate, waiting, the Father, planner, and creator and provider of all, waiting. The answer could go any way. Could it be more questions? Could it be uncertainty? Could it be yes? Could it be no? The angel waited. Was it a patient wait? Was it a joyful wait? Surely it was all that and more. And then Mary said yes. But the angel had to wait. And in many ways in our lives, we have to wait too. Another point that I'd like to point out is the nowhere special theme that's in the gospel. The angel Gabriel was sent from God. That's a pretty powerful starting point. You don't get any bigger than that. You don't get any more powerful and glorious, and that's the place to be. That's command and control. That's the situation room. Angel Gabriel was sent from God to where? A podunk little two-horse town in the backwater region of a suppressed and unhappy region. A town of Galilee called Nazareth. Google Maps ain't gonna point you there, boys and girls. To a virgin betrothed to a no-name guy, Joseph, whose family ancestry was storied but had seen better days. Oh, and by the way, the girl's name was Mary. Again, nothing special names, nothing special times, nothing spectacular place. And yet God was at work there. And then finally, those words of Gabriel, "For nothing shall be impossible for God." In these days, as we are gathering as best we can, ourselves and our family and our community around us, whether it be physically so, whether it be in our prayer and grateful memories, whether it be on the phone or the computer screen, don't give up on them. Don't give up on yourself, because God hasn't either. Friends, would you rise and join me as we remember that faith that gathers us today? Do you renounce Satan and all his empty works and all his empty show? Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, born of the Virgin Mary, crucified, died, and was buried, but rose from the dead and seated at the right hand of the Father? Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, resurrection of the body, and life everlasting? This, dear friends, is our faith. This is the faith of the Church. We're proud to profess in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. And with gratitude to the Lord, let's offer prayer.
and lay leaders. May they continue to guide us in living the truth of the gospel. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the leaders in all the branches of our government, may they promote and protect the dignity of all human life, from conception to natural death. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our brothers and sisters in all countries where they have little to eat or drink, or who suffer violence and persecution, may they have their voices heard by those who can bring them comfort and relief. Let us pray to the Lord. For each of us, may we continue to spiritually prepare to celebrate Christ's birth. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all in our parish family who are sick and in need of healing, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our deceased loved ones, including Owen Griffith, Jason Casmer, and Linda Logan, may they rest and rejoice in the eternal embrace of God's love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Offer the Mass for the intentions of Jan and Carl Martorum. For their needs and prayers, we pray to the Lord. Loving God, hear our prayers as we strive to know your will and follow the plan you carve out for us. We ask all this through Christ our Lord. Sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Lord, accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. May the Holy Spirit, O Lord, sanctify these gifts laid upon your altar, just as he filled with his power the womb of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for all the oracles and the prophets foretold him. The Virgin Mother longed for him with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist sang of his coming and proclaimed his presence when he came. And it is by his gift that already we rejoice at the mystery of his nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exultant in his praise. So with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, which without end we acclaim. Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus Dominus Deus Sabaoth. Lei sunt caeli et terra, gloria tua. Hosanna in excelsis, benedictus qui venit in nomine Domini. Hosanna in excelsis. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holy. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Kevin, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters, fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. That with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostle, and all the saints who pleased you throughout the merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. The Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, to live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer one another a sign of peace. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, dona nobis pacem. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Thank you. Son's nativity, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. A couple of announcements before we go. Please be seated briefly.
This Wednesday, the 23rd, is our normal day of Eucharistic adoration. Given current COVID restrictions, the Blessed Sacrament will be on exposition here in the courtyard immediately following the 8 a.m. morning Mass until 9 a.m. for 1 hour. Our Christmas schedule of Masses and times for the Sacrament of Reconciliation are included in this weekend's bulletin. Please take a copy home with you as you leave today. Extra copies may be found in the small table near the sacristy door. Volunteers are needed. Once again, after Mass, please help sanitize the chairs for the next Mass. Thank you.
And thanks, everybody, for your presence at Mass. Anyone in from out of town to join us? Just us local folks. Okay, good to have you all. Sorry, where are you in from out here? Texas, home from college? No, you're living out there. Where in Texas? It's a big state. Houston. All right, good to have you. Welcome to the town.